have our race leads at the FTC Audi R15 LMP car, and he's catching up with the team Kitty here at the moment. That isn't that exciting because he is currently 3 laps ahead of Team Kitty. Currently in the picture we have the former race leader, 10 Man Project, and I know for a fact that right now Chris Dunson is riding, and if you have a look down the live timing at Simitov.dk, you see he's really going fast right now and pushing very hard.
Yep, but let us just have a small recap here.
Yeah, let's go through the pack.
We have in first position at the moment, we have the FTZ car. The FTZ car driven by Henning Pettersen and his teammate Gert Nielsen. They are in front and they've driven 149 laps in total. And on second position, we have the very manly team Kitty DK. They are 3 laps down at the moment, so they've done 146 laps. Their last laps, however, the team Kitty car was quite a bit faster actually. That is actually the top runners of LMP. Given that the Black Arrow SimSport car has yet again disconnected, and given that they've already used up their server restarts, the server has not been restarted because of them. And also the Team Aegean Lola Judd car has forfeited, as so Iron Man.
Yeah, Jeppe.
Jeppe, exactly, Jeppe Rasmussen.
Yeah, I think that is very impressive, actually.
Yeah, he started to feel pressure. So he quit it around an hour ago or so.
Yeah, but next up we have the GT class.
Exactly. In front of the GT class at the moment, we have the former Yamaha Lister. They've done 147 laps, and one lap behind them, we have the Ferrari front team Bernie. Then comes your teammate car.
Yeah, we have Chris in the car currently, and I can see he's pushing very, very hard at the moment, trying to catch up, and he just passed Steam, I assume.
His last lap time is 1:55.6, which is very respectable. So he's going quite quickly. They have the 10-man project. Seems they are a lap down compared to the team Bernie Racing. So actually, the top three of GT1, none of the cars are actually on the same lap at the moment.
Yeah, but we have to remember we're not even halfway yet.
No, that's correct. The halfway mark is in half an hour. So, nothing, of course, is decided yet at all.
A lot of racing yet to do.
Yeah.
And now we are going into the dark. That's gonna be pretty exciting too, I think.
Yes, I've actually just heard from the drivers what we talked about earlier on in the day. That going down the back straight, that is an old runway. If you are an aviation guy, and that was labeled 0927, that means the runway is directly east-west. And that means when the sun is going down, we are racing down the runway in a westerly direction. You are getting the sun directly in your face, and it's very hard to see the turn-in of the last corner.
Yeah, when you enter the last corner down there, it's very, very hard to see anything, actually.
Yeah, and the sun is on its way down now, so that is, at the moment, in a very short while, that would be one of the challenges the drivers are going to be facing.
Yeah, but right now, the drivers going right now in the cars have a little luck, because they have a better possibility to get used to that. if you switch in an hour or so, you'll get your you just went in the light, then you had a break for an hour or two, and then you get in the car again, and then everything's dark.
You might be right. I don't know how other drivers feel, but the transition on my behalf isn't that important. But I think I can follow your idea that it might be easier that it gets darker progressively.
Yeah, exactly.
I think most of the cars are actually in the middle of a stint, except the Team Culling Racing and the Formula Yamaha cars, because they have both been in for a fix of the lights, along with, I think, the Steen Steinecker, of course, also alone, so he's endured longer than Rasmus, the loader.
Yeah, that's quite impressive.
But he has a long way to go, so...
Yeah, I think in an hour or so, I think he'll lose the pace too.
Yeah, he'll probably, he can take a small break or something, but his position in the race is all right for taking a break, but he doesn't have that big of a gap, so... Anyway, continuing on where we left off, leaving the top 10, in position 4, we find the guy we actually just talked about. If you can find him, here he is, Steen Steinecker, in the Ford GT, and he's done 140 laps. The next position is Team Culling Racing 3 with Ben Juul and Gerd Nielsen. They are in position 5 and they've done 139 laps. Moving further down, we find the Frank Kaubik and John Strolke Corvette. They've done 138 laps, so not as far behind as they started out, actually. They got off to a very bad start and started 4 laps down, I think it was, compared to everybody else because of their technical problems during the beginning of the race.
Yeah, but if you have a look at the Carbage Strunk and then you compare them to the our 24-hour race, they actually managed a lot of progression, I think.
I agree with you, they certainly aren't as inferior compared to some of the other teams. Compared to what they were at the 24-hour race.
No, and they are much more. They are more on the track now than off the track.
Exactly. They are making a bit of a few mistakes. For example, what you just saw during this braking zone. But I see them a lot less off the track than on the track than we used to do. And I think also the experience and just of doing this endurance racing kind of thing. How they set up their car, how they set up their equipment, not least, that has gone a lot further for them.
Yeah, as far as I know, they used to do a rally. And it must be quite a new environment to get into this endurance racing.
Yeah, you are probably right. But one of the things they did have at the 24-hour race was that they were running a projector, and this projector wasn't properly calibrated in conjunction with their PC, so when it got dark they couldn't see anything, because of course a projector isn't that good at showing dark colors. Anyway, so that is the state of the race at the moment. So the cars DNF'd is the Team Ezion car, the Black Arrow Sim Sports car. Both of them not running anymore.
So I'm sitting here looking at the weather at the track currently, and I can see that both the ambient temperature and the track temperature are slowly but steady decreasing now. So that must be because of the dark closing in.
Yeah, of course we are. We're approaching the evening and the night at this point, and expecting the temperatures to go down would be a natural thing. I know that we don't know how big the temperature range will be, of course, but that some cars benefit more than others on behalf of the temperature. I know,
yeah, exactly.
For instance, that the Lister Storm really benefits from high temperatures. And I think we will see a change in dominance in with regards to the pace of the cars.
Yeah, that's going to be very interesting to see what who can do better in the cold weather. Another aspect of the endurance and the racing in the evening and the night.
Indeed.
So, Les, as far as I know, you just switched with Peter, and how did you you had two stints in the car?
One and a half, rather.
Okay, how did it go?
Well, actually, the stints actually went okay. As I said, our car is really, really glad of the higher temperatures, and that has managed us. Made us able to go a bit quicker than we were before the last server restart. It's really nice to behave at the moment. I did have a small collision with the team calling Aston Martin, actually, simply because we were going really quickly because of the temperatures, and he surprised me by braking a bit earlier, and I made a bad decision. I went on the outside. And I hit him inside, so both of us went off, and I had a little tap in the wall, and a light went. Of course, I didn't know that light went out, which meant that I actually, I think, 10 laps or something before I was informed that I had to go in and repair it. So I had around 30 liters left in the tank, so about 2/3 of the stints were done when I pitted in. A bit too early. But otherwise, it's really nice. The track is really, really great at the moment. There's lots of grip, and before when I was driving, the sun wasn't a problem yet. So
yeah, I noticed that too. Actually, at one point you set the fastest lap time of the GT class.
No,
the
I don't think I did.
Yes, you did at 154.292.
Oh, but the 10-man project car has improved on that later, because that's
Has
done 154.232.
Yeah, it's very, very close.
If you follow the link cycling at the bottom of the screen, you can all see these lap times we're talking about. And the fast lap energy T class at the moment is actually only divided by 60 thousandths of a second.
Yeah, and I think it's a very good picture of the pace in the track right now. It's very, very close between the two of them.
Yeah,
and then the next car is Team Blaney Racing, and it's also very, very close at only 0.4 of a second.
Yes. This is right. The racing at the moment in the GT class is much closer than it is in the LMP class.
Yeah, unfortunately the cars is divided by, all the cars are divided by at least one per lap, but the pace is very similar throughout the whole class, actually.
Yeah, more or less. Whom of the two front runners, or the two last runners in the LMP class, is actually wearing a bit? I've seen both the FTC car, FTZ car, and the Team Kitty car being quicker option. But it doesn't seem like any of them has the final say at this moment. It's up and down whom of them are the quickest.
Yeah, but the team KDDK, they have to find something, because right now they have to do 3 laps to get up on the SCC car, and that's hard.
That's hard, but that's nothing a small incident can't fix.
That's right.
If the FTZ car slides off somewhere or hits a GT1 car, that's it. That could be those 3 laps that the team Giddy car needs.
Yeah, that's the aspect of riding two classes. There's always meeting. You never just go by yourself and get into a rhythm, because there's always someone to break that rhythm, and you have to be on your marks all the time.
That is right. Compared to a single class race, you can't just go on autopilot as you could. You're not able to do that. You cannot do that in a multi-class race. Anyway, that was a small update. I am leaving you for the moment, and we will be back to make an early update at some other point.